Hello my dear children, how are you all? In this video we are going to continue with the chapter number 7, Living and Non-Living Things, and we will study about the characteristics of living things which are present only in living things. Before watching this video, you should read from page number 72 till page number 74. After that only you will be able to understand it more clearly. So let us start this video. Hello children, today we are going to continue with this chapter of living and non-living. We had studied few points in which we can studied the differences between living and non-living. In this, we will study this in detail. What is the real, on what grounds do living and non-living things differ? So there are some characteristics which are present only in living things. Like, several living things move. You must have seen animals moving in search of food, human beings moving in search of food and shelter or to escape the enemies. And besides that, our body parts also move. Plants, you must have not seen moving here and there around in search of food and shelter, but if we observe carefully, there are some plants which show movements, like touch me not plant, jisko hum chui mui ka paudha bolte hain. When we touch it, the leaves of the touch me not plant, they droop down, wo band ho jati hain. Isi tarah sunflower, it turns its face to sun. When that is also a movement, then the flowers of lotus and water lily, they also show visible movements. But non-living things cannot, some non-living things move, like they move, but they do not have the characteristics present in the living things. Like non-living things like car and etc., they move, but we cannot consider them as living. The second characteristics of living thing is that all living things are made up of cells. As the building is made up of brick in arranged in layers, in the same way, in the same manner, the tiny cells are arranged in our body, and a living organism is made up of many cells. There are also some organisms which are unicellular, like a bacteria, a fungi, amoeba, paramecium. They are made up of, their whole body is made up of only single cell, and so they are called unicellular. And when they, in their lifetime, that there is no change in this number of cells, but they, in their lifetime, the size of the cells may change. And bigger the animal, more are the cells, the number of cells. Okay. The third characteristics we are going to talk about is that living things grow. You all have seen, if you observe yourself when you were a child and now when you have grown up to class 6, somewhere here. So that is all, and again further you will also grow. So what happens in a human being, growing in a growth of a child, there is always the increase in the size of the body and body parts, and up till one age this growth is always there. Same happens in a, if we talk about a seed, what happens, a seed grows like this, and ultimately a seedling comes out when after germination, and finally a tree is also it forms a tree, in a huge tree. So all these living things show growth. Here one non-living thing is also there, like it is a growing crystal. You will study in a higher classes that from the super saturated solution we form a crystal, and this is how a crystal is formed. Though it is growing in size, but it is not increasing in the number of cells, or it is not increasing internally, so we will not consider this as a living thing, even though it is growing in the size. Similarly, a heap of sand also grows in size, but we are not going to consider it as living thing. We know it's a non-living thing because there is no division of cells, but in living things, when the growth occurs, there is the division of cells. Even when there are only one cell or single cell unicellular animals or unicellular organisms, there is only the growth of that particular cell. It does not increase in the number of cells. Okay. Now, the another characteristics of living things is that they have a definite lifespan. If you see this table, there you can see different living organism, like bacteria is having the lifespan of 20 minutes only. Housefly is having a lifespan of 1 to 4 months. Mouse 2 to 3 years, and we'll go down. And here, if you see horse, it's 25 to 30 years. Ostrich is 45 to 50, and human being it is 60 to 80. And if you go to tortoise is 120 to 150 years. So there are different lifespans of living things, which is not shown by non-living things. Now, living things reproduce. You all know that dogs, cats, they give birth to the new animals like themselves, and this is called reproduction. Even birds also, they also give birth to they lay eggs, and from those eggs they hatch, the birds hatch their eggs, and from those eggs small chicks come out, or baby birds come out, and in a few days. Similarly, frogs, snakes and spiders and mosquitoes, they hatch from eggs. Plants, you know, it's also a living thing. They are produced from seeds. And can you imagine what would happen if living things could not reproduce? What would be the answer? There would be no living organism on the earth. Now, next characteristic, living things respond to stimulus. What is stimulus? Anything, any change in the environment is called stimulus, which can cause a reaction in your body. The change can be the change in temperature, the change can be the change in light, the change can be the change in touching, if someone touches a living organism, or something touches the living organism, or the change in the sound. These are called the stimulus. So there is a respond to stimulus. The living things, they respond to stimulus. For example, if you accidentally touch any hot thing, you will quickly withdraw your hand from that hot utensil or your thing. That is called your response to that particular stimuli. And stimulus. Plants may be aisa hi hota hai. For example, one plant is mimosa plant, that is touch me not plant. When you touch the leaves of mimosa, what will happen? These leaves will droop down. They become, they close themselves. Why? Because they are sensitive to touch. So, agar aap kisi change ko ya stimulus mein aapki body mein kuch change aap show karte hain, that is called response to stimulus. के इसी तरह जब हम एक स्मॉल एक अगर आप एक एक्सपेरिमेंट करें और एक स्मॉल स्पॉटेड प्लांट को विंडो के पास रखें जहां से लाइट आती है, सिर्फ वहीं से लाइट अगर आए, तो आप कुछ दिनों बाद देखेंगे कि प्लांट की जो टिप है वो जिस डायरेक्शन में लाइट आ रही है उस डायरेक्शन की तरफ वो मुड़ जाएगी. और इसको भी हम रिस्पॉन्ड टू स्टिमुलस ही बोलेंगे, क्योंकि चेंज हो रहा है उसकी बॉडी में ड्यू टू द लाइट. और इसको हम बोलते हैं, इस रिस्पॉन्ड को हम बोलते हैं फोटोट्रोपिज्म. मतलब लाइट की तरफ उसका क्या रिस्पॉन्ड है, तो उसको हम बोलते हैं फोटोट्रोपिज्म. कुछ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स जो होते हैं लाइट देखकर भागते हैं, जैसे कि कॉकरोच एंड अर्थवर्म. तो दे विल शो नेगेटिव फोटोट्रोपिज्म, वाइल द प्लांट, हम जिस प्लांट की बात कर रहे हैं जो कि लाइट की तरफ बेंड हो रहा था, उसको हम बोलते हैं पॉजिटिव फोटोट्रोपिज्म. इसी तरह एक दूसरा रिस्पॉन्ड होता है, रिस्पॉन्ड टू इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ अर्थ, द ग्रोथ टूवर्ड्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ अर्थ. जैसे अगर हम रूट्स की बात करें, तो रूट्स हमेशा अर्थ के नीचे जाने की कोशिश करती हैं, और स्टेम हमेशा उसके अगेंस्ट ग्रो करने की कोशिश करते हैं. तो जो रूट्स और स्टेम है इनको हम बोलेंगे पॉजिटिवली जियोट्रॉपिक, और इस रिस्पॉन्स को बोलेंगे जियोट्रॉपिज्म, और जो स्टेम है उसको हम बोलेंगे नेगेटिवली जियोट्रॉपिज्म, नेगेटिव जियोट्रॉपिज्म. क्योंकि स्टेम हमेशा अर्थ के अगेंस्ट ग्रो करता है, तो स्टेम को बोला जाएगा नेगेटिव जियोट्रॉपिक एंड रूट को बोला जाएगा पॉजिटिव जियोट्रॉपिक. ओके, दिस वाज रिस्पॉन्ड टू स्टिमुलस. अब दूसरा है लास्ट हमारा पोर्शन, लिविंग थिंग्स नीड फूड. वी ऑल नो कि जब हमें टाइम हमारा टाइम हो जाता है खाने का तो वी वॉन्ट फूड और हमको भूख लगने लगती है. सो ये दिस इज़ द केस फॉर एवरी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. एवरी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म नीड फूड बिकॉज दे नीड एनर्जी टू ग्रो, टू मूव एंड टू डू अदर लाइफ प्रोसेस. ग्रीन प्लांट्स आर मेक देयर ओन फूड सो दे आर कॉल्ड ऑटोट्रॉफ्स एंड बट एनिमल्स दे डू नॉट पेयर देयर ओन फूड. दे आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन फॉर देयर फूड ऑन animals or on plants, so they are called heterotrophs. So now we have completed this portion of this chapter, and in the next video we will take the next portion of the chapter and we'll try to complete this chapter. So children, so watch this video carefully, try to study this carefully. जो भी आपको नए वर्ड्स दिख रहे हैं, न्यू वर्ड्स हैं एंड आपको समझ में नहीं आ रहे हैं, तो उनको आप प्लीज़ डिक्शनरी में से उसका मीनिंग देखिए, लिखिए उसको एंड ट्राई टू रीड इट नाइसली. ओके, थैंक यू सो मच.